हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 8, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन ई-लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ डीएवी मॉयल पब्लिक स्कूल। आई एम योर सोशल साइंस टीचर मनीष साबरे। डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट प्रोग्राम्स लॉन्च बाय गवर्नमेंट फॉर द अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ वीकर सेक्शन। This is the topic from unit number 22, safeguarding the marginalized. Dear student, here the programs launched by government: Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana launched in 25th of June 2015. It is primarily a welfare housing scheme launched by central government. The houses would be distributed to the needy sections of the society, and a subsidy on loan would be provided by the central government, thereby making affordable housing for the economically weaker sections of the country. Special preference would be given to senior citizens, women and SCs and STs in allotment of these houses. So dear student, this is our Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana launched by central government. Next Yojana is Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. This launched in 28th of August 2014. Under this Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, any individual above the age of 10 years and does not have a bank account can open a bank account without depositing any money. The scheme targeted the people living below poverty line, BPL, but it is beneficial to the everyone in our country who does not have bank account. Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Next scheme is Stand Up India scheme. This launched in 5th of April 2016. The Stand Up India scheme aims to promote entrepreneurship among SCs and STs and women. This Stand Up India scheme provides composite loan for setting up any new enterprise between rupees 10 lakh and up to 1 crore. So it is all about Stand Up India scheme by central government. Next is Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. Dear student, this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana launched in December 2016. Under this income declaration scheme, the government would mobilize the money for utilizing and meeting the welfare needs of the poor population. So this is our Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. Here Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana, launched by central government in 22nd of January 2015. Dear student, this is the important scheme by government. It lays special emphasis on financial empowerment of the girl child. I repeat, it lays special emphasis on financial empowerment of the girl child. Through this scheme, the parents of any girl's child below 10 years can open a saving account for their daughter and operate it till she attains an age of 21 years. After that time, they can withdraw the money and use it for her marriage or higher education. the scheme offers a high rate of return, even much higher than PPF, Public Provident Fund. So it is all about Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana. Last scheme is Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. It is launched in February 2015. The scheme provides a social security to the people. A large number of population in India live in rural areas, and these people do not have access to insurance scheme. Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana is an initiative to cater to such a sections of our population so that they can enjoy the insurance benefits at minimum contribution. Dear student, these are the schemes and Yojana launched by programs launched by government for the upliftment of the weaker sections in our country for their development. Next one is people aspirations and our national goals. Dear student, we learn in the safeguarding marginalized. We understood the definitions of marginalized. We learn about who are the marginalized categories in our country. So on your screen you are seeing the marginalized categories in our country: children, SC, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, other backward classes, OBC, men, and some minorities are the marginalized people in our country. India has captured the imaginations of the world, we know. There is a definite possibility that India can become a prosperous nation if we get the reach of poverty, ignorance, and disease. Our growth processes should be more inclusive to ensure that the marginalized and weaker section benefit from the economic growth. They should ensure the improvement of social infrastructure, particularly in fields of health and education. So that is why in our country, we know that India is a democratic country, and Indian government provides the facilities to all people living in the country, health facilities and education facilities, we know. Even today, the important challenges we face today are the unevenness of our growth processes and the inequalities that remain in our social institution. We must ensure that the interest of the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, backward classes, minorities, women, children are protected and justice is provided to them. The continuing the crimes against the weaker sections, men and children, are a matter of disgrace in civilized society that emerge as a leader in the science and technology. So this is the people's aspirations and our national goals. We know, dear student, in our country, the government provides all the schemes, all the facilities to protecting, to safeguarding marginalized people in our country. We learn about it. Here, I hope you understand today's topic. So, dear student, here, the assignment question on today's topic. You can write these questions and its answer in your notebook. Dear student, I hope you understand today's topic. Thank you for watching this video, for making us a part of your day. Thank you, dear student. We will meet in next period with new topic. Thank you for today.